Welcome back to TenorShare, everyone. Lately, I tried to switch my phone from Android to iPhone. But the data transfer between Android and iPhone isn't quite easy. The well-known way of transferring data is the move to iOS app. So I tried it, and it started fine. But during the transferring process, I meet transfer error. Unable to migrate. Transfer stuck on 1 minute. It's pretty annoying. Why transferring data from Android to iPhone is so hard? Then I go to YouTube and Google check it out. And I find out 5 ways to solve this issue. Now let me show you how to do it. Open Move to iOS on your Android and factory reset your iPhone. If you would like to try the method without resetting, you can jump to here. 1. Check Wi-Fi or switch Wi-Fi. First, you need to know that Move to iOS app relies on a stable Wi-Fi connection. If your Wi-Fi is in a bad condition, the transfer could be interrupted. So make sure your Wi-Fi is working properly, reboot your router, and try to transfer again. Press and hold power button on iPhone, then you will see the start over option. Tap it, then you can restart the transfer process. Second, if your Wi-Fi is in good condition, forgot and reconnect the Wi-Fi. For Android, go to Settings and tap Connection, Wi-Fi, tap the gear icon, and forget the Wi-Fi here. Then reconnect the Wi-Fi again. Again, restart the transfer process by holding power button on iPhone. Third, force restart Android and iPhone. For force restart iPhone, press the volume up and volume down, and then press and hold the power button. Keep holding till the Apple logo appears. For Android, press and hold the volume down and power button. Keep holding till the logo appears. Then restart the transfer process. Fourth, use a different app to transfer data. Download SHAREit app on both of your phone. Android can find it on Play Store. iPhone can find it on App Store. Open them on both phone. Tap Send option on Android phone. Now you can choose what kind of data you want to transfer. Files, videos, apps, photos, music. Here we can try photos and music first. Choose some of the photos and music, or all of them. Then tap Send button. Authorize all the options it needs. And then tap Receive button on iPhone. Now Android will need some time to detect iPhone signal. Wait a minute, or you can tap the 3-dot option on Android. Tap Connect to iOS, and then use your iPhone to scan the Android QR code. Then the transfer will begin, and you can see those photos and music transferring to your iPhone one by one. Okay, let's check it out. Photos are transferred perfectly to our iPhone now. But looks like the music didn't transfer to my iPhone. SHAREit is similar to the Move to iOS app. It doesn't transfer apps data. And most importantly, both of them rely on strong Wi-Fi connection and the transfer process will take a very long time if you have a lot of data. If you don't have a good Wi-Fi or you're in a hurry, I recommend you guys try iTransGo. Fifth, transfer Android data to iPhone with iTransGo without erasing iPhone data. This is an expert data transfer tool. It can transfer Android videos, photos, messages, music, and other data to iPhone with 3 steps. I already put the link in the description. Once installed, connect both your phone into your PC or Mac and open iTransGo. Click the Start option. Here we'll need to install Connect app to complete the transfer. Click Install. And allow all the files authorization while those windows pop up, so that we can transfer them. Then you can see here are many types of data that can transfer, not only videos, you can choose music, contacts, photos, or other data. Let's select them all and then click the Start Scan option. iCareFone will start to prepare the data you need to transfer. Once the scan is done, we can start to transfer. Click the Transfer Data option. You can see my videos, photos, music, and contacts. They are transferred from my Android to my iPhone one by one. Okay, the transfer is done. Let's check them out. Photos, videos, music, apps. It's working perfectly fine. Transfer with just 3 steps. Go try it. Okay, that's it. Hope this video is helpful to you. Subscribe for more iPhone and Android tips. See you next time.